What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Trash Talk.
Di pertandingan kemarin, Kelly tidak bermain terlalu banyak ya, Bu?
Iya, betul.
Back with me, Rocky Padilla, and today I have the guy who just made history with Hang Tuah, Nation Josh. Welcome to the show, Nation.
Hey, what's good, brother? appreciate it.
Appreciate your time too.
Yeah, no problem.
So, Nation, you're from Hawaii.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Can you just talk a little bit about basketball in Hawaii?
The basketball in Hawaii is not really popular. It's kind of behind in the sport. Hawaii is mostly known for football. It's a football predominant state, so. For me to make it this far from basketball, you know, it's kind of it's real under the radar, so it's really tough, it's challenges.
How did you get into basketball then?
My dad was a basketball player, so it just came naturally. I was always the tallest in class, and I've always had a fond for it, so I just gravitated towards the game just naturally. So,
is it true that I heard the rumor that you have Filipino blood in your?
yeah. No, my mom is Filipino. She's a half Filipino. My grandma's 100% Filipino. So I'm a quarter Filipino. I'm working on getting my Filipino passport right now, trying to get over to the Philippines ASAP. It's a really stressful process, and it's like a lot of hoops you got to jump over. Yeah.
Is it close though?
No, I got all the paperwork. I can trace my ancestors all the way back to the Philippines, which is my great grandma. She was the last to be born in the Philippines. I have all the birth certificates that lead all the way back to me. It's just a matter of the rules. There's some rules and stuff that, you know, I'm trying to work out right now.
Is the reason that you want to get your Filipino passport is to play in the PBA or?
Yeah. I'm trying to get to the PBA. Definitely trying to get to the Philippines. I know how, I've talked to multiple guys, multiple agents, multiple lawyers, and representatives from the PBA, and they're trying to help me work on getting it. So it's not like I'm in this alone.
Okay. And then before you came to Jakarta, you told me that you were trying out in the G League for the Salt Lake Stars.
Yeah, the Utah Jazz's G League team. I was working out for them. Going to the training camp, it was a great experience too. Great experience. Getting to experience the different work ethics and the coaching and the lifestyle. I was there for 2.5 weeks, and it was definitely a grind. And unfortunately, I got waived on the very last day. I was the last cut, and. It was heartbreaking because I really felt confident that I was going to stay. I felt like I played really well. But I just realized it wasn't my time, so I'm going to try again this upcoming year.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then on your Instagram, I saw a video. And even on YouTube, you showed me that you played with a lot of this Seattle NBA players like Jamal Crawford, Nate Robinson, and also Kyrie Irving.
Yeah.
So how did you get invited to that game? Let's talk about the Kyrie Irving game first.
Okay, Kyrie Irving. I was young, man. I was 20 years old at that time. Kyrie was 1 year old. I think he's 2 years older than me.
Okay.
But I was playing really well in the program, the Seattle program. Shout out to Jamal Crawford, real good guy.
Super nice guy, I think.
Super nice guy.
He is one of the nicest guys.
Yeah. I applaud my tip my hat to him for everything he's done. But he basically approached me with the opportunity and asked if I wanted to play in the game. He didn't tell me who it was going to be. He didn't tell me which game it was going to be. He just asked me if I wanted to play in one of the All-Star games this year. I said, of course. So when I got an email one day, I was at home playing 2K, and I got an email and said that you've been selected to play in the blah, blah, blah game. And it showed me the rosters, and it said Kyrie Irving, and I couldn't even believe it. And when I got to play with him, when I met him, it was so crazy because he's just like one of us, like,
yes.
You know, seeing him on TV, but he's really just another person, you know, plays basketball just like us. He's a real cool guy. And I found myself watching him on the court. Like, I was only 20, so I never really played with pros before like that. I was still in college. I found myself just watching him from on the court. Even though I'm on the court playing in the game, I'm watching like a fan. So it was crazy.
How did you know? You say Jamal Crawford invited you personally?
Yeah personally.
So how did you and Jamal meet?
How did I meet? Basketball, the pro-am. So it's not like we have a connection or a relationship at that time. It was just him reaching out like, hey, you want to play? And then he had his people get in contact with me, and that's how it all went. But as the years went by, I put in pro-am for multiple years as it went by. Now I formed a relationship with him. I don't got Jamal's number or anything, but he does follow me on Twitter. So every summer there's an invitational pickup game. So when all the pros get back in town, they want to keep running. They have invite only games. So you'll get a text message, a group message, and they'll let you know the location. You can't bring anybody with you. Just show up by yourself, and you gotta be on time. They're real. I'm usually late a couple minutes, and they get on me every time. So Seattle has a bunch of guards. They don't have a lot of bigs. So luckily, I get texts every time. I'm always invited.
So and then there's another video about on you and playing with Zach LaVine.
Yeah. That was the All-Star game 2 years ago. I got selected to that as well for the All-Star game. Zach LaVine, DeJounte Murray, Nate Robb, Jamal, Terrence Williams, Spencer Hawes was there too. So I did really well in that. This is more further along in my career, so I was very comfortable in that game. So I played a lot better, and it was just I'm just grateful for all the opportunities.
Not a lot of people knows about this though.
Hey, no, but it's on YouTube. You can go check it out if you want to go look at it. It's on there. Seattle Pro-Am All-Star Game. You can go look at it.
There'll be a clip on there.
Okay.
Really cute.
Okay.
So let's talk about IBL now.
Okay.
So before the playoff, you had an eye injury, right?
Yeah.
A big swollen eye.
And
then you had to wear the goggles for the first game against Garuda. It only lasts for... Oh, okay. Only lasts for 4 minutes.
4 minutes.
What happened?
So I was kind of nervous about it because I was fresh off the injury, so I wanted to, you know, protect myself. So I asked for some goggles. When I got the goggles, warmed up in it, shot around, went to practice the day before, it was fine. As soon as the game started and we started really running up and down, my goggles was fogging up and I couldn't see, no peripheral vision. So I had to take them off. There was no way I was gonna be able to play the game. And we started the game off really slow in that game, so we were in a hole. So I was like, okay, I gotta take these off. This might be my last couple games. I gotta play 100%. So.
And then you guys actually made history. This is the first time Hang Tuah made to the Final Four. So before the season started, did you ever expect you guys to be here?
To be honest, when the season first started, me and Keenan, we definitely had this plan. We definitely believed that we were a playoff team. Especially, I'm not saying our side is not the better, stronger side, but our side, there was more opportunity for us to make it, you know, to this point. So opposed to the other side with Pacific, ASPAC, and PJs, it'd be tougher. We felt like we could be a top three team on this side. So we didn't care who we went against, BIMA or Garuda. We felt like we could beat them in a three-game series. So we just wanted to get in. That was just the main focus, make it, and we would do the rest. So
talking about Keenan, you and Keenan Palmer.
Yeah,
Keenan. Chemistry is so good.
Chemistry is good.
On
that's
the court.
My guy. That's
so
my guy.
How do you get that connection really well with Keenan?
You know, it's crazy because it's not like we had time, like, never played before, never met each other until we got here. It's just work. It just was working. We don't beef at all on the court. We have a perfect. We get along off the court, and it just translates to on the court. So when we're on the court together, we don't worry about stepping on each other's toes or anything. We both know that we need to do the best that we can every game. We can't have off games. We know that. So we get each other involved all the time. If I'm having a bad game, he'll try to get me involved. If he's having a bad game, we'll try to set him some screens and get him an easy one so he can get it going.
And then you're a young guy, Abraham Buenas.
Just
won the Rookie of the Year award.
Well deserved.
Yes. What do you think of his game?
Buenas was a surprise. I knew he could play in the beginning, but I didn't know he was like this good. Like, he plays with a lot of confidence, and that's what we need. Guys with a lot of confidence, you know, compliment Kelly, me, Keenan. Buenas was a nice surprise, and ever since the beginning, now we kind of expect that from him. So he did really well this year.
Okay, let's talk about the upcoming matchup against Satria Muda.
Yeah, that's him.
It's 3-0, but you almost had them in Jogja.
Yeah.
How you like your chance?
I'm saying it's recorded.
It's recorded.
We will beat Satria Muda 2-1. I'm going to predict that right now. I would never lay down and say that they're going to beat us. They're very beatable. I think they're very beatable. They're a very beatable team.
You know they're watching, right?
Cool. If you guys are watching, believe me, we're hungry too. So just know that.
All right. So that's all the questions. So thank you.
Thank you. No
appreciate
problem.
It for the time.
No
good
problem.
Luck. Good luck against SM.
Thank you, thank you.
Would love to see that upset though.
Hey, it's coming, it's coming. March 22nd. Somewhere I don't know.
In Batam, it's in Batam.
Jakarta though, come out to that one.
So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and comment anything about this interview. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't. And thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.